बॉस ने रिपीटेडली डू. एक्सेलेंस देन इज नॉट एन एक्ट बट अ हैबिट, सेड एरिस्टोटल. गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल प्रेजेंट हियर, द एचओडी ऑफ आईटी डिपार्टमेंट डॉक्टर आशीष जाधव सर, फैकल्टी मेंबर्स एंड ऑल माय डियर फ्रेंड्स. वेलकम टू द डे 3 ऑफ समर इंटर्नशिप प्रोग्राम SIP 2020. I'd like to invite Dr. Pallavi Chavhan ma'am to continue with a session on pointers. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Ritika. I'm sharing my screen. Please wait. Can somebody confirm the screen is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Abhijit, madam, just a minute.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Abhijit, are you there? Can you please record this video, because many students would be in the stormy area of Ratnagiri and all those places. They cannot attend because there will be no electricity at many places. So please record it and then save the video in the Google Classroom so they can see it later.
Yes, sir. We have recorded all the videos and we are recording this one from the start also.
Okay, okay. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir. So, good morning, everyone. Good morning, students. Today, I'm here to deliver a session as a part of our internship program. And the entire session is based on the concept of pointers. So this session is going to help you all. Doesn't matter if you're a first year student, second year, third year student. So I'll be starting from the basics of the pointers. Then we'll see how to use pointers with different data structures like arrays structures, how to create array of pointers, then how to allocate memory dynamically using dynamic memory allocation concepts. And in further sessions of our internship, it will be taken ahead with functions and all. So objective of this session is to make you aware about the concept of pointers, and everything I will try to demonstrate, you just observe the steps which I'm performing here and try to guess what is happening. At the end of every statement, I'll try to give answer of that statement and what will be the output of our execution. So let us start with the concept of pointer. You take any programming language, like we will be working here with C programming. So as soon as we declare something in our C program, it takes some amount of memory. So it depends upon the declaration. Like if you declare a character variable, it will take 1 byte. If you declare integer variable, it will take 4 or 8 bytes depending upon the structure of compiler and so on. So very first statement inside main program we do is declaration of our variables. And as soon as we declare, the memory is allocated. So where exactly that allocation taking place? What is its address? How to retrieve the contents from that address? All this thing we can do with the special variable, and that variable is pointer variable. So in short, pointer is nothing but a variable that holds address of another variable. And I would like to show here that what happens when we go for declaration of some variable. So let us begin with a simple declaration that I include a standard input output file in C, and I start with the main program. So this is my main function. Though it returns value, I have not written int. If in case you are having a practice of writing int main, so at the end of your program there must be a return zero statement. So I'm returning nothing, and just take one declaration of variable. Suppose I take one character variable and the name of variable is x. So we declared a character variable. At this moment, 1 byte is reserved in memory. So when we declare the variable, usually our memory allocation is taking place with the stack, because this is now a static allocation taking place. And then we will see how to allocate memory dynamically. So 1 byte is reserved. If you want to check this, you can go for checking size of this. So size of this will be reflected by number of bytes. We know that 1 byte is reserved. So number of bytes means we are going to return a count. Hence, I'm using here a format specifier %d. And to make it more specific, I'm writing number of bytes equals to percentage, and we want to check number of bytes taken by variable x. So manually we have observed that one byte is reserved. So let us run this. We are going to check size of x as number of bytes. So number of bytes equals to 1. This is what we have extracted, the bytes reserved from bytes reserved in the memory. Now let us check at what address this byte is. So I can go for the address by simple statement, and in that printf statement I can access the address of variable x simply by typing %x. If you have done C programming earlier, you must be aware of writing such expression, but always in a scanf statement when we take the input from user. So what does it mean? Whenever I type % and variable name, it represents the memory address. At this address, the value is. So we want to extract, we want to print this address of variable x. For this, we will not be using a format specifier %d. Instead, we are using a format specifier %p. Meaning here is that it is the address of memory location, and this memory location is, we are printing here by a format specifier %p. It means whenever you print addresses, whenever you handle the pointers, we use the format specifier %p. You might have observed in some statements that %u is x or %x is used, but in some cases it might appear to work in some environments, but in some cases it is actually undefined and it may not work. So whenever you work with the pointers, make a practice of using a format specifier %p. So as soon as I run this, the address of variable x is here. So I have not mentioned a next line character. Suppose I put here a next line character /n. You all must be knowing the escape sequence. This is one of the element of escape sequence. It will take you to the next line. So let us run this. And now see, the number of bytes taken by variable x is 1. And this is the memory address of that location. So far we have not used any pointer variable. Now we want a pointer variable that will hold this address. We have not placed in any of the variable. Now I want a pointer variable for x, and x has a data type character. So when you declare the pointer variable, it is related with what type of variable you have. Like I want a pointer variable for x, so that pointer variable is should be pointing to a character. So while declaring that pointer variable, we take character, say *ptr. Ptr is my name of pointer variable. And wherever in declaration asterisk appears, it means that this is a pointer variable. You can see the difference here. X is a normal variable that will hold some character value, and ptr is now a pointer variable. How we have identified it? Because it has asterisk in front of it. So it is a pointer variable. Now question about this, why we have mentioned here character? Reason is, this pointer variable is it should point to a character variable. So it is a character pointer. And now we can hold address of this variable x in a pointer variable. So we can do like this, ptr equals to address of x. We know that how to access the address of variable x by using %x. So if you do like this, ptr equals to x, this will be a wrong assignment because x will hold some character value. We want address to be assigned to a pointer variable. So we wrote ptr equals to address of x. And now if we go on printing this address that is present in a pointer variable ptr, so our format specifier will be p. Again, I'll give here new line character so that our next address will appear on the next line. And here we'll put ptr. Now, observe that I have not mentioned here asterisk. This asterisk appeared as a part of declaration when we declared a pointer variable. Now it holds address of variable x. So to print that address, we will only use the name of pointer variable, that is ptr. So we are referencing here to the address, and later we will see how to refer to its content. Now let us run this. Both the addresses should be same. Yes, these are the number of bytes given by size of function. Now this is the address we have printed using ampersand x, and the next address, which is the same memory location, we have printed using a pointer variable ptr. Now I want to check that what is the value available at that address. Actually, this value is present in variable x, and for example, let us initialize it to some character. X is initialized to a. So in C programming, when we give some initialization, since it is a character variable, it will appear in single quote. Now we want to check what value is available at that address. So the type of value is character. Again, be careful, our format specifier should be %c, because we are going to print here a character value. And why I am putting here slash and this, I want to go to the next line so that I can differentiate among the outputs. Now here I want to print what is available at that address. In that case, we will use asterisk ptr. So many students have confusion at this place. What is the meaning of asterisk ptr and what is ptr? Here please understand that this is not any declaration of pointer. In fact, we call it as a dereferencing. Here we are referencing, means we are getting the address, and here we are dereferencing, means we are extracting what is the value available at that address. So if you print ptr, it will give you address, and if you print asterisk ptr, it will give you what value available at that address. So what do you expect as output of the last statement? It should print value a, because ptr holds address of x and x has the value a. So indirectly, using pointer, how to access the value of that memory location, we can go for asterisk ptr. Now let us run this. Now see, the character a is printed. You may consider that instead of this statement, why don't we put a statement printf %c and simply putting x. Of course it will work, it will print a character a, but here we are demonstrating the use of pointer variable and how to access the value, how to access the element available at that address using pointer variable. So this difference is important in every program. When you refer to the address, you only use pointer name, and when you refer to the value at that address, usually we call it as a dereferencing, you use pointer name with the asterisk. So this was a simple program to demonstrate the use of pointer variable. Now I'll make a small change. For example, I will go for now new pointer variable. This was all about the character pointer. Now this time I'm going for one integer pointer in int asterisk p. It means you are declaring one pointer variable that will hold address of integer variable. To make it more simple, say I have the variable y and now asterisk p. So let us consider that this pointer variable p will hold address of y, something like that. Now I want that this pointer variable is to be initialized to null. So you can write like this: your pointer is initialized to null, indicating that it is not pointing to any memory location at present. So just imagine, if your pointer is not pointing to any memory location, so what content it will print, or how you will perform dereferencing. So in case of dereferencing, definitely you'll get a segmentation fault or error. So you can print the address like printf. Let us try to print the address by using pointer variable. The name of pointer variable is p. So it is null, it should not give you any address. It is indicating that it is a null pointer. Now let us try to perform dereferencing. So printf, I want to print what is the value available at that address. Now what type of pointer it is? It is pointer to the integer variable, so it should hold some integer value. That's why I am putting here %d and try to print that value using asterisk p. This will create a problem, because it is very clear in program there is no value present, or in fact we have a null address. We are not locating any memory location here, so it will be an error. It will be a segmentation fault. So because there is no value to print, this is how you can create the null pointer in the beginning, and later you want to assign something to it, you can assign it. Now let us go for pointer declaration and initialization at one place. So I take an integer pointer, like I take int num, it is a integer variable, and I take another variable, that is my pointer variable. And here in the declaration itself, what we can do is we can assign the address of variable num. This form is known as declaring and initializing a pointer at the same location. But be careful that what address you are assigning to pointer p, you are assigning address of num, so that variable must be declared. If I take here ampersand x and x is not at all present in my declaration, so you will face a problem. So num is my integer variable and its address I'm putting in a pointer or variable. So let us assign some value to num. Let us say I have a value, some value in variable num, and now try to print the value as well as address. So I print the address of this variable num by this statement. You can print it by p, and value, integer value, earlier it was character value in earlier example, now we are printing the integer value. So value at this address. So value is of type integer, my format specifier will be percent b, and now this can be printed by referring to asterisk p. Again, same concept, because we are working with the integer variables, p refers to the address, it will print address, and in printf statement asterisk p refers to the value at that address. And let us try to run this. The address is given here in the first statement, and value present at that address is 10. So this is how you can create different variables like floating point, double, and you can create the pointer variables for those and manipulate those pointer variables. Now in next example, we'll take simple expressions using some floating point variable, and we'll try to manipulate using some increment, decrement, addition, multiplication, and we will see its effect, its impact on our variable. So let us take one float now, because we have handled integer as well as character variable, and I am taking one floating point variable, say d, and I am assigning a value to d as 1.0. Okay, so we have one variable. Now I want a pointer variable to hold address of this floating point variable. So in the next statement, I take a pointer variable. That pointer variable name is suppose pd. Of course, you can combine these two statements just by separating comma. You can put here asterisk pd as your pointer variable. So again, I repeat, this pd is a pointer variable to floating point variable. Okay. Now let us hold address of d in pd. For that, we write a statement pd equals to ampersand d, which we are putting address of variable d in pd. Now, this next statement is important. Like, I am putting here asterisk pd equals to 2.0. Please try to understand this statement. Here, in pd, we have placed address of variable d, right? And in next statement, asterisk pd means you are referring to the value now, not the address. You are dereferencing here. So value at that address, you are changing it to 2.0. Earlier, the value was 1.0, and now it is replaced by 2.0. So by dereferencing, we change the value. And in next step, I do something like this, x equals to asterisk pd. So what do you expect? What should be there in variable x? Yes, there should be a value 2.0 in variable x. So let us print it. The format specifier will be %f. We are dealing with the floating point value. And now we are trying to print the value available in variable x. So let us check. Sorry, x is not declared. I'll add here variable x. And now, yes, the value of x is 2.0 because it has assigned, it has been assigned a value asterisk period, and in earlier statement we change it to 2.0. Again, in next statement, what we will do is we'll do something like this: y equals to asterisk pd plus 10.0. For that, I need to again declare a variable y. Okay. So what do you expect as a value of y? Asterisk pd. It is at present 2. See here, we made a change to this value, and 2 plus asterisk pd is 2, and I am adding here it 10. Now you can print the value of y also. Before that, I'll have one more statement. I'll change the value of pd to something like this: asterisk pd plus 5. Now let us check the updated value of our pointer. Since it is a floating pointer to a floating point variable, your format specifier is %f, and you're trying to print the value available at that address. So you're dereferencing it. Okay. Now let us run this. So after running, see, I have not given here slash n just to differentiate the output. After running this code, we'll be getting the value of pd as 7. Because earlier it was 2 here and 2 plus 5. Though I wrote only 5 in integer form, your compiler will automatically convert it to 5.0. That is floating point representation. Now, next change we will do is that, say, the contents dereferencing pd is equal to asterisk equal to 10. I hope you can guess this expression. We have solved many such expressions in the beginning, in your first year, that this is equivalent to the multiplication statement. I can write it as pd equals to pd multiplied with 10. So this is simple multiplication with 10.0. So what do you expect as a result of this? This 7, the latest value of pd was 7. We have displayed it. It is getting multiplied with 10. And now try to print this value. Again, it is a floating point value. And we are accessing the value, not the address. So asterisk pd will appear. This is a dereferencing. Now let us run and check what value we are getting. Yeah, again, putting a new line character, the output will be differentiated from previous output. So this is out of assigning another value. This is out of adding 5, and this is multiplying 10 with the content available at that pointer. Okay, so we have not printed here y. You can also print the y, you will get corresponding value. Now we have multiplied something with the value available at pointer variable. Now just imagine what will happen by this expression if I write plus plus asterisk pd. So this operator, it is known to you, it is a pre-increment because it is occurring just before a variable name. Suppose it is occurring after the variable pd++, we call it as a post-increment. So let us now focus on the pre-increment. Always remember that now there is increment operator and there is dereference. You are performing dereferencing also. So precedence is always higher to dereferencing here. So first it has a precedence, and the next precedence will be given to the unary operator plus plus. Now what do you expect here? The present value of pd is 70. We displayed it, and now plus plus pd is happening since it is getting increased by 1. And if you print pd, it should print 71. So let us check this. Print f, a floating point value, and that value we are extracting using the reference operator. So when I put here slash n, and now it should print the desired value. Yes, it has printed 71. It is the result of our pre-increment operator. And this pre-increment, you can hold in some variable, you can print that variable and whatever operation you want. So let us work with the post-increment. Suppose I take a variable A and now I perform asterisk PD plus plus. So let us guess what can be the output here. At this point, what we printed? 71. So presently, the value of PD is 71. In next statement, we are performing post-increment. So quickly, I will revise. Post-increment means first the expression is assigned to A. The value of this expression will be assigned to A, and then increment will happen. And again, about precedence, your dereferencing has higher precedence than your unary operator plus plus. So what is the latest value of PD? It is 71. It is assigned to A first, and then increment will happen. So as soon as I print A, it is a floating point value. What do you expect? What it should print? It should print a value 71. Again, A is not declared. Let us add A here in our variable list. And now, the value 71 is printed. I hope it is clear to all because it is the post increment. First value of this expression is assigned to A, and then the increment is happening, right? So we have performed many operations with the contents available at our pointer variable. See, we have not directly worked upon D. Ultimately, the value of D is getting a change here because of the dereferencing, and everything we operated using a pointer variable. Okay. Now next, a very simple example I would like to take. The logic is known to you. You might have performed swapping of two numbers, two integers many times. So let us perform this swapping but using pointer variable. So for that, you need two integer variables. Say I take A and B as integer variables. But this time, we will not swap these integers directly. We'll swap them using pointer variables. So we need one pointer variable for A, another pointer variable for B. Students, let me tell you, we are taking as many variables as we need here in this program, but this is not a good practice. When you will be working in the industries or in some company, it is very restricted. There is a rule that unless you need a variable, you should not declare it. So try to use minimum number of variables. And in that case, dynamic memory allocation is very beneficial. This is actually what we are working with, the static memory. Because in the beginning, our aim is just to explore the pointers, how they work, how to declare, and how to handle their values. In dynamic memory allocation, we will cover all these problems. Like, we'll only take those many memory locations which we want. Not randomly we'll take the variables, we'll assign the values, and we will operate if required. Otherwise, the declaration will be of no use. It is just occupying some memory in the stack and nothing else. So let us swap these two elements, A and B. So we need two pointer variables, say asterisk PTR 1 for A and asterisk PTR 2 for B. So as soon as you declare the variables, you can hold their addresses in pointers irrespective of the initialization. So I hold in PTR 1 address of A. You can hold in PTR 1 address of B also. It's your choice. And in PTR 2, pointer variable 2, I hold the address of variable B. Now we have two pointer variables. The logic of swapping is very simple. We usually take one temporary variable of the same data type to swap the elements. Now for swapping, we need some value. So let us take the values from user, say integers. So integers will ask the user, and user will give input for variable A and B. Now this time, while taking input, we'll pass the address of variable A and address of variable B. So input will go in these two variables. Now let us swap. So, for Swati, a simple logic we use, we take a temporary variable, and there, in normal swapping, you would have done like this, temp equals to a. But we don't want to do like this. We want to do this by pointer variable. So, in temp, we will hold the value available at address ptr1. So, that can be taken by ptr1, asterisk ptr1. Asterisk means referring to the value. If you remove this asterisk, it means you are referring to the address, and this statement will become invalid, because temp is a normal variable, ptr is a pointer variable. So a valid statement is this: we have taken value in temp variable. In next, let us exchange asterisk ptr 1 equals to asterisk ptr 2. So you have exchanged this, the value of b is now placed in a. And finally, asterisk ptr 2 equals to temp, because ptr 1 value we hold in temp variable. Now the exchange is done, swapping is done, and if you print those values, you will get the swap value. So how to print this? So printf, say I give your message after swapping, the values are printf. Our nature of the value is integer, so I will go for %d%d, and those values will print, will not print by a and b. Let us try to print it by asterisk ptr1, means what is the value available at this address? The address is address of a. So what is the value at this address, and what is the value at this address 2, ptr2. Okay, now try to run this. We give some input. Program should ask two integers. Yes, my first integer is 1. Oh, simple input I will give, and second integer is 2. So after swapping, it has become 2, 1. But you have not represented the result just before swapping. That can be done here, like printf, and here I give the information available for variable a and b before swap. So before swapping, what is the value? You can print like this, %d%d, and now we'll print in terms of pointers only. So what is before swapping? It is asterisk ptr1 and asterisk ptr2. So you will observe the difference. These are the values before swapping, and these are the values after swapping, because note here that this is a swapping logic we implemented, and then ptr1 and ptr2 will always represent the swapped values. So let us check here. We'll give two integers, say 12 and 34. So before swap, it is 12, 34. After swap, it is 34 and 12. By slash n, your output will be again formatted. You can put slash n and have formatted output. So it means we have swapped the integers using pointer variable. So step by step we'll move ahead. In next case, we'll take arrays with pointers, then how to access the array elements using pointers. But up to this, I hope it is clear to everyone how to declare a pointer variable, how to use it to access the memory location, as well as to access the value at that memory location, and how to use it for simple expressions like swapping we have done here. In earlier example, we perform some operations with the pointer variable. Okay. Now moving ahead, I will take another example, but this time we will be working with arrays. So this is a concept of arrays with pointers. So let us write a small program that will print the addresses of array elements. So initially, without pointer, we'll print the addresses, and then we'll take one pointer variable, and then we'll try to print the addresses. So I take here one declaration. This declaration is indicating that we have one array called as x. It holds 5 elements. Size of array is 5, and the nature is integer. It is an integer array. In next declaration, or here only I'll combine my declaration of I. Because I'm going to work with number of elements in array, I need to iterate. I need to repeat the scanning printing process. So So we need a loop, and I is a variable we will be using for iterations. So I take I as a loop variable. Now to print the addresses without declaring any pointer variable, we can do like this. For we start the array from 0, then I less than 5, because the first element is available at location 0, x of 0, and the last element you will find at x of 4. The total number of elements are 5, from 0 to 4. So when you iterate, you should start with 0 and you should stop at 4. So condition we are giving I less than 5, and every time the increment of 1 will happen. So in this for loop, let us try to print the memory addresses. So printf, the memory address we are going to print, remember that our format specifier is %p. And now to print the memory address, we will simply write ampersand x of I, because every time it should print, once the I is incremented, it should print the next memory location. Students, observe that we have not taken any input for our array. It is not holding any set of elements. We just declared an array. So as soon as declaration is done, the memory locations are reserved for 5 array elements. So the memory locations are reserved. We can easily extract those memory addresses using the expression ampersand x of I. So let us check what will happen. They will be displayed consecutively because we have not placed slash in here. So this is not a good form of representing your output. Let us put a slash in here and see 5 memory addresses you should get. So these are the addresses. Now let us understand these addresses. First is the memory locations address for first element of array. Now recall that our first element of array is x of 0. The second element's address is this, x of 1. Now compare these two. Do you find there a difference of 4 bytes? Yes, it is the first memory location's address. This is the first element's address. This is the second element's address. Because your array type is integer, integer declaration is taking 4 bytes. So for first element, we need 4 bytes. And those 4 bytes will be starting from 60. So 60. First byte, 61 second byte, 62 third byte, and 63 fourth byte. So your fourth byte of first element will be available at 63, and from 64 your second element of array is starting. So this is the way memory addresses are displayed for our array. Array size is 5. If you change the array size for n number of elements, it should display those many elements. Now let us check what will happen by this statement. If I write printf %p, means again we are going to display the address, and I type here x. Okay. Or before that, I will try to print %x. So it will display the address. It will display only one address. Get the difference between these two statements. This printf statement is repeated 5 number of times for 5 elements of array. But this printf statement is executing at once. It is out of the loop. And in printf, you are mentioning address of x. So if this is the case, your compiler will give you the address of first element of array. So let us check this. Now see, this is our last printing. This is what and x we printed. This is the memory location of first element of array, which is exactly equivalent to this, which we printed using for loop. Or you can change it to this also. If I remove ampersand, your printf statement will again print the same thing. So you have two options. If you want to access only the memory location of first element in array, you can do like this. And usually, pointers are operated like this with the arrays. We just want the memory location of first element. Once we get it, by increment, we can move to the next memory locations. So we have added this line and we got the address of that. Now, let us take some example where we will perform some arithmetic with array elements using pointers. So, for that example, I take one integer array, the same array we will take of size 5, and we will try to add up these elements. Means, let us perform sum of array elements, in short. So, to perform sum, when result will be generated, we will hold it in some variable, and initially, your sum should be 0. One more variable we need for iteration in a loop, that variable is I. Now we want say 5 integers from user, so I'll give a message to the user 5 integers, and that we are going to handle with the addresses, not directly the elements. So let us enter the 5 elements. For that we need a loop that will be starting from first element of array, which is at 0, I should be less than 5, so it will repeat up to 4, and every time the location index will be incremented by 1. In this, we will take input as scanf, and it is integer value, so %d, and we are giving at what location this value should go. So it should go at the ith index. So every time when I is 0, your input is going to x of 0. Then I become 1, the given value of user will be going to x of 1 and so on till the condition is true. Now once the input is ready, you can sum this up. In fact, you can sum up in the same for loop. Try to avoid using unnecessary for loops. We may take the next for loop to perform addition, but that is not required actually. So as soon as you take the element input, just go and add it to the sum. So sum equals to sum plus. We will add it using the concept of address. See, observe in our program, we don't have yet any pointer variable, but still we can refer to the addresses of the array elements. And how is that? If I put here x, you observe in the earlier example that whenever you refer to the x, it will give you address of first element of array. So to iterate in for loop, what I will do, I will just add I to this. So my expression is x plus I. So whenever this is evaluated, x plus I, you're accessing a particular element from array, a memory location, but we don't want the address. We want the value available at that address, and it can be easily given by asterisk x plus I. I hope you are getting this expression. See, this is just like dereferencing. This is the memory location. To iterate for all 5 elements, we will go on adding I, and at this memory location, what is the value available? We can get it by asterisk. And this way, sum will take place for all the 5 elements, and no need to print inside a loop. We will print it outside. Our sum is integer, so I will write sum equals to say %d, and that sum will simply print by a variable sum. Now let us run this and just check what output we are getting. We have to enter 5 integers. To manually compute sum, I am just giving a small range of values for array elements from 1 to 5. So sum is 15, and manually if you see, your sum is 15. So this is the way we took the input and we performed the sum with the concept of dereferencing. Otherwise, what you would have done, instead of writing this expression, you would have written here x of I. So whenever you refer to x of I, you are directly accessing the element, not the address. So here in round parenthesis, we write x plus I, so we are referring to the address, and asterisk is indicating what value is available at that address. So I hope this is clear to some of the elements using pointer. I'll take another example with array and pointers. In that, we will try to move to the next memory locations from the first memory address using pointer. So let us take one integer pointer, again same x I will take, but small change I am doing. I'm initializing the array to the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is my array with initialized values. And now I take one integer pointer. See, this is only one pointer variable, PTR. It is not array of pointers at present. So our aim is to hold the memory address of first element in this pointer, and using this address we can move on, we can access the further elements in our array. So what we will do, see, we are having this assignment PTR equals to ampersand x of 2. So understand? Yeah.
I'm sorry to interrupt, ma'am. Some of the students have certain doubts. So should I tell the doubts now, or should they unmute themselves and ask?
No problem. We can take doubts, because it will be good if we take simultaneously.
Yes, ma'am. So Prateek was having a doubt. He wanted you to please repeat that line. Sum is equal to sum plus star of x plus I, that one line.
Okay, earlier example.
Yes, ma'am. Earlier.
Okay. I'll take it here only. What we did there, we took some variable to hold our result, and one variable to iterate. So what we did in for loop, we just go on adding the elements. Now this time we will not take input because the array is already initialized. I hope Pratik it is clear. Now yes. Let us go for computing this now. This loop will repeat 5 times. We have 5 points. Now, initial sum is 0. So every time our sum will get extended, like previous value plus the next value. So yes. Sum plus. Now our array, if I put here x, this is making my statement wrong. Reason is, this x will be giving you address. It is not giving you value. Right? Yeah, just check it here. I'm commenting here, and here printf percent %p, and here I put x. So if you run this, the address is printed, right? And yes. This is the address of first element 1. Now if we do like this, this is wrong, because we are adding a value with address. We don't want that. But here we can add up the value present at that address. This is called derepressing, right? Yeah. But we want to repeat it for all the elements. That is why I placed here round parenthesis, and we will iterate this till I is satisfied. I hope it is clear.
Yes, I got it.
Okay. So let us move ahead. Any other doubt, Abhijit?
No, ma'am.
Okay, you please convey me. If students have doubt, we'll take it immediately. Okay?
Sure, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. Now, let us take, this is again very simple and easy to understand example. I have this array with the initialized element, and again I take one loop variable to iterate, or not required, I'll directly take a pointer variable, asterisk PTR. Now, this is a single pointer variable, so it will be able to hold only one address. Please remember. And which is that address? We want any of the address out of these 5 elements. If you want to start from the beginning, you can hold first element's address. We will do something different. Like in PTR, I'm going to hold address of index 2. So students, observe that you are holding address of third element. Index is 2 means it is third element, 0, 1, 2. Here is the index 2, and the value at that point is 3. So this pointer is pointing to what? Third element. Now, what we will do, we will just try to print what is the value at that address. So value we are printing means percent %b, and just print asterisk PTR. Same case, earlier example mein jo hua, asterisk x plus I. So PTR is what? Address. And what is the value at that address? We will display it by using dereferencing operator, asterisk PTR. So we expect that 3 should be printed. Let us check this. Yeah, 3 is printed. So this is the value available at our address. Now in next statement, let us manipulate our pointer variable. So now student will guess this output. So printf, I put here percent %b, and this time I'm printing asterisk ATR minus 1. So just apply the logic, what is happening?
Should be printed.
What should be printed?
2.
Ma'am, Janvi is saying 2 should be printed. So everyone is saying 2 should be printed.
Yes, yes, 2 should be printed because you are decrementing the pointer variable by 1. It means you are decrementing the index by 1 and you will get directed to. So it should print 2. In the next printf statement, if I have a statement like %d and this time I print asterisk ptr plus 1. So you are increasing the index by 1. So what it should print? 4. So let us check. Yeah. Our display will be consecutive because I have not used slash n. So this is out of asterisk ptr. This 2 is out of asterisk ptr minus 1. And this is 4 is asterisk ptr plus 1. So this is how you can manipulate the memory locations. But remember that the value of ptr is not getting changed. We have just performed ptr minus 1 and that memory location's value we're displaying. But this subtraction has not happened in the address. The address is constant. And always ptr is pointing to address of third element. Sorry, address of third element, that is 3. That will not change. So this way we can access the elements from array using pointer. Now we will do one more addition to this. We will try to create array of pointers. But before that, let us check what will happen by this. I have this array x, one pointer variable, and I do something like this, ptr equals to x. So I hope students will be able to guess what is getting assigned to ptr. So if you print here the address by a %p, and if you print ptr here, the address of first array element should be printed. Okay, so this is the address of first element, but to assure, we are not sure here. Suppose to assure this, let us print like this, printf asterisk %p, parameter specifier is p, and now I print here address of first memory location. Can I do like this? We are accessing the first element, that is at 0th index, and its memory location. So it will be given by, yeah. Slash n is playing important role to understand the output. So I put here slash n and see, these are the memory locations. This is the memory location of first element. This is also a memory location of first element. But see the difference how we access them. This is by using individual elements address and this is using a pointer variable. Okay. Now this will help you ahead. Let us now create array of pointer variables. Or I would like to give some exercise for 2 minutes to the student just to check whether they are getting it or not. So I'll be giving here some statements. Students, please do this and I'll execute it. And we will compare our outputs. Okay. So for example, this code fragment is for you. You observe this. If you have a notebook with you, just try to compute the output and then I'll show you the result. You can compare your output with the result. I hope it is done. Abhijit, can you assure?
Ma'am, the peak is saying address.
Okay.
So I think we'll have to compute it on the screen.
Yeah, I'll just wait for a minute so that those who are doing, they will complete. And now I'll show the output.
Yes, ma'am.
Students, you please maintain a notebook and pen with you. If you have online compiler in your mobile, that is again good. If you have laptop, no problem, but do it with any of the facility available with you. Okay, now I'll start explaining here. We have one integer variable var, and pointer to that variable is p. So in that we maintain the address of var. So when you print ampersand var, it prints address, we know. When you print p, p is a pointer variable, it will again print address. What if you simply type var, it is a normal integer variable, so it should print the value 10. If you print asterisk p, p is a pointer. So what is the value available at that pointer? That is printed by asterisk p. Dereferencing is happening here. So it should print 10 again. And now this might appear different to you. Like you are first taking address, and what is the value at that address? So it should print 10. I hope all of you are getting this statement. This is the address of var, and what is the value at that address? We print it by star. Now next, again, if you print p, I think this is a repeated statement, value of pointer p, it will print the address, and this statement will also print the address, but this address is different. Understand here that and var is the address of variable var which you hold in pointer variable p, and finally and p is the address of pointer variable. At present you are not holding it in any of the variable. For that we will introduce a special variable pointer to pointer later. Okay, so this last statement should give you address of your pointer variable. I again repeat, address of variable var is different and address of pointer variable p is different. So these two values are different. So let us check this and just compare with your outputs you have. So address of var is printed first. Again, address of var is printed by using pointer variable p. Its value is printed by referring to the variable name. Again, using dereferencing asterisk p, we are printing this value 10. Third time, what we are doing, we have the address, and what is the value at that address? We are printing by asterisk and percent var. So third time, 10 is printed by that statement. And now this is the address printed out of this statement. It is repeated. And address of pointer variable p. So observe this address, it is the address of pointer variable which is different from address of variable var. Okay, so I hope it is 1 minute. Yeah, it is okay now to proceed ahead with the dynamic memory allocation. As of now, I expect that students know how to declare a pointer variable and how to access the value available at that memory location using pointer variable, and how to handle the pointer using arrays, and how to access the elements of arrays. Now let us quickly move towards dynamic memory allocation, because it is very important topic and it is widely used because it's something that talks about saving memory. So whenever you go for static memory allocation, you may have wastage of memory. Dynamically, if you allocate memory, the amount which is required for your program only. So one major difference I would like to tell you here, whenever you allocate memory statically like int a I do, so that is a static allocation. That allocation is happening with the form of memory called as stack. And it goes in a proper order, a particular order. But that will not happen in dynamic memory allocation. The nature of the memory there used is heap, and that goes in dynamic way, that goes in random way. So randomly the memory location will be allocated. So let us perform how that.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah.
I had one theory doubt about pointers. Everything we have been doing with the pointers can be easily done in other way. Like we can use address of the variable or by some other means. Why do we need pointers? Like,
yes, see the examples we have taken here that you can easily do with the normal variables. Okay, the role of pointer is very important when you go for dynamic memory allocation. That's why we are starting here with dynamic memory allocation. The reason is why we use pointer, because pointer gives user a flexibility of using variables, right? And using those pointer variables, we can manipulate the variable values at particular memory location. In fact, it is a powerful aspect of any language. Like if you are using pointers in C, it is very powerful. But you might have studied data structures there also. When you create linked list, you create queues, there also the concept of pointer is used, because it is very powerful and easily you can access the elements. I hope you are getting this doubt, because the exercises which we have done, that can equally be done without pointers. So moving ahead for dynamic memory allocation, pointers are...
Sorry to interrupt, ma'am. Ma'am, would it be possible to take a 10-minute break here?
Yeah, sure. No problem. So by what time we will join?
Ma'am, it is 11:43 currently. So we'll join by 12 o'clock. Is that time?
No problem. Yeah.
Okay. So before we go on break, I just had a little announcement for all of you. To mark your attendance, you will have to go on to Google Classroom, register with your login with your registered email IDs only. You'll be able to go to the attendance section and you have to mark your attendance. The attendance link will be open from 11:45 till 12:30 p.m. only. So just make sure that you mark your attendance within that time frame. And you just have to click on yes to mark your attendance. You don't have to comment yes. You just have to click on a button that will show yes. So your attendance will be marked. And also, anybody marking their attendance after 12:30 will not be considered. Their attendance will be discarded. Thank you, ma'am. We'll resume the session by 12:30. Yes, ma'am.
In this 10 minutes, if students are able to solve that 5-minute quiz, that will be great, which is there in Classroom. Google Classroom.
Okay, ma'am. No issues, ma'am.
Okay.